in terms of the PASSA itself, because from the word go, it is not as the normal emergency shelter or the other shelter reconstruction where we tend to use experts. This time we are targeting the community themselves. These are very purely laymen who you are trying to convert into good supervisors.
After evacuating the family from the flood prone areas to these areas, we initiated three camps. We had a camp here called Kizurini camp, we had another camp, Garage camp, and we had another third camp, Singwaya camp. All this we did with a lot of collaboration with the stakeholders, including the Red Cross teams. Mm-hmm. And that's why we had the formation of the committees. The committees were basically formed by the Red Cross teams.
When the camps were established, Kizurini camp had a total household of 340. Even though we had lost all of our commodities, but we feel that we have our friends who can help us to go back to our normal life.
Kiangalia kule ambako tulikuwa tunaishi kitambo, hata kama ndio tulikuwa tuko na nyumba zetu, lakini ilikuwa kuna wakati mwingine ikifika usiku, pengine kama mto pengine unaleta maji, usingizi wetu hauko comfortable, mpaka inabidi pengine usiku wazee wanaenda mtoni, wanaenda kuangalia je yale maji yako vipi. Hata ule mngurumo, ile sauti ya maji pia ilikuwa inaeka watu katika hali ya taharuki. Na PASSA ilipokuja tuelimisha, huku mahali tulikokuja ni salama. Naweza nikasema kwamba tuko juu na tuko very safe. Hatua ile ambayo pengine naweza nikasema nimepiga ni hatua ya kwamba nilikubali ile hali, na kwa kukubali ile hali nafikiri maisha yangu ni kama mbaye sasa naona yatarudi pale ambapo yalikuwa, kwa sababu ni kama mbaye akili yangu imetulia, sasa ni kuendeleza tu miradi.
Pesa ya kwanza iliyoletewa ilikuwa 1018. 1018 hiyo ilikuwa inasimamia kununua miti, fito, kamba, na nilipe fundi wa kuweka ile bidirika hadi kukandika kuweka ule udongo. Baada ya kuweka huo dongo, nikaletwa mabati 20 na cement mifuko 25. Mifuko 20 na 5 nikawa sana ngoja ile pesa ya 29,000. Ilipoingia 29,000 nikanunua mbao za roofing. Hizo mbao za roofing zilienda 7,000. Nikanunua misumari 500. Nikaitisha fundi akaja akaitisha 3,500.
Mimi nilikuwa nataka na inaweleza kuwa mimi nitawasaidia kujenga ama tusaidiane kwa pamoja. Kwa sababu sasa tukisema nanipatia mimi peke yangu, hiyo pesa sasa na nyinyi mtakuwa hamna msaada wote wa kujisaidia. So mimi nimesaidika kwa ile project ya kujenga, na pia naye mwenye nyumba naye amepewa msaada, naye amefaidika pale pale.
When the Red Cross people came, they were registering them using the lights. First of all, we started selling the lights so that everybody could have the line registered with the beneficiary, with his or her name. So we registered them and we ensure that line has an anniversary.
We thought that if we let them buy from the local, or rather from the existing distribution network, it is going to take a long time. A time which we did not have, because the long range were almost catching up with us.
Red Rose platform, we used it during registration of the beneficiaries. So we had our volunteers using mobile devices to collect data from the community members and also to get their images into the system. And then we used it during the post-distribution monitoring after the first cash transfer. It's a very good tool to use when we are trying to gauge how we are moving with the program. So far, it is the best tool we can use at our level.
The planning meetings, which were convened by the CSG at the CSG level, were all well coordinated. I was also in charge of the monitoring and the evaluation of the progress for the program in conjunction with the staff and the volunteers. We used to move to the field to make sure that we monitor the process. If not so, I made sure that that is done through the project management committees led by the chairpersons of the specific PASSA committees.
In this methodology of reconstruction, we were able to engage a lot with the community and know exactly what the community is, what they face. So for the first time, we were able to get the facts and the baseline right.
It's been part of this learning review for the methodology that Kenya Red Cross used to implement their shelter response, where they were using a combination of cash transfers and in-kind assistance through the PASSA methodology, which empowers the beneficiaries to be able to construct their own homes. The interventions that were done were very useful, and one of the key learnings was the way the project empowered people, the trainings they received, the local committees that were set up, who were working with the beneficiaries of the project in the construction of their homes. So the way that the families were relocated to higher lands where they are not at risk of flooding is one element of the project which was very good. And the beneficiaries, they all realize that they are now in a safer location and they will not be affected by floods in the future. The quality of the homes that they have built, they all attest that the houses are of better quality, they are stronger, they feel safer in their homes.